Hi everybody, Corrie Thorne, spiritual healer. Welcome to the weekly vlog. I feel like it's very important to get this one out today. It is a massive storm in where I am in Alberta, and I think I've seen more snowfall today in this storm than I've seen all of last winter. It is crazy. We've had like, I want to say 2.5 feet of snow so far today. And I'm like, we're just being kind of dumped on. But as I was shoveling it, and that's why my hair looks like this, so fuzzy curly, is that as I was shoveling that snow, my messages started to come. And as I looked at the snowflake, I looked at, you know, the uniqueness that so many snowflakes could pile and fall, and not one would be alike. But they could so come together. And it was just like this beautiful, picturesque image of something that is, you know, there's a storm blowing through. It could be horrible. It could be tremendous. But, you know, if you want to look at the negative of it, or you can look at, as I was shoveling, the kids next door are sliding down the steps. And as they're sliding down the steps, they're laughing, and I could hear laughter and belly laughs. And I'm out there trying to get through all the snow, and they're laughing at me. And then I'm looking at all the flowers and stuff that had died that are still like on the ground. And I'm like, there's so many ways that we can view life. There's so many perspectives. And right now, this week, that's what it is that I'm looking at life from. It's like, there's so many ways that we could view the world. There's so many ways that we could view our own lives. Where we are within our own selves is how we view the world. Where we are within the energy of how we're feeling is how we view the world. So a few weeks ago, we would have had a whole lot of people being all, you know, like traumatized, upset. And then today, those same people could be flipped over onto the other side and just say, you know what, let's all come together. Hooray, hooray, hooray. Because now we got now there's a happiness. So it's like wherever we are within ourselves is how we're going to be responding within the world. So it's understanding that because we are all unique, and because thank God we have free will and the freedom to have our own minds and think for ourselves still, is that because we still have that we have an opportunity to feel how we need to feel in the moment. And we need to honor that for each other. And it's like, and just, you know, let people have their moments. We all have moments of celebration, and we all have moments of grieving. We all have moments through loss, and we have to honor that and respect each other and return to that. In the storm that's out there today, there's also beauty. So it depends on how we're looking at the world. Are you going to look at it at the horrible storm that's happening? Are you going to look at the beautiful snow that's falling? And that's right. So which side are we on? What side that track are we on? And so it's the same thing in life of when we, you know, because what happens is we're on the fear train or we're on the faith train. It's like we're either inspiring or, you know, or they're inspiring and rising each other up, or we're influencing and impacting to like pull people to our sides, like a tug of war. And right now the energy is coming through with, say, let's just stop the tug of war. Let's allow people to feel what they need to feel. Let's stop de-energizing with language and words and fear. Let's stop that world that's kind of manipulating and with motives to manipulate. Let's stop living in that place of, you know, de-energizing our words, our thoughts, or using words and thoughts that are like that. And let's start charging back up. Let's start plugging back into the main source. Let's start plugging into this sort. Let's start having faith again. You know, let's get back on the faith train. I've never left, but let's get on the faith train. Let's get back into a place of hope. Let's get back into a place of caring for each other. Let's get back into a place of using words that bring about awareness of higher vibrating energy, of I understand where you're coming from. I was where you were a few weeks ago, and I lived in the same fear. I might have a different view, a different perspective, but I understand the emotion that you have. I understand how you're feeling. I understand that that's your story, and I understand that that's what you believe in. And so when we have that, well, that usually will often start changing the energy, but it's like, but it also starts us making us stop and pause and think, oh, you know, maybe we are a lot more alike than what we think we are. We may have different views, but maybe we are a lot more alike. So this week truly is into that energy of, you know, are we going to start charging ourselves back up no matter what? We should have been doing this a while ago, but it's like, are we going to start rebuilding rebuilding on fear or rebuilding on faith, and start to allow ourselves to see the world as unique, that we're all unique. We might be seeing a storm, or we might be seeing something beautiful. And however we're viewing it right now is how we have to view it for whatever place we are in. But what we have to recognize is all of the magic, that the miracle magics that happen in seeing those amazing snowflakes, how they develop. So look beyond the energy of what's happening right in front of your eyes, and look beyond that. Just think of what it took for us to get here. Just think of how much energy we wasted. Just think of how much effort we put in, and how much that effort's paying off, or how much, you know, we need to start continue. If we got this motivated, we got to stay motivated to do other changes. Like, and so many ways that we can look, if we start looking beyond, look at how those snowflakes were created, look at where they came from, just think of how many are falling, or, you know, we're just using this one as an example. But having a different way of empowering and looking at life, we have an opportunity to start to explore life differently, because every day is a new opportunity. Every day is a chance for a rebirth. And from where we are right now, what's in our control and what can we change? And, you know, where do we go from here? So there's a lot of envy story that's around. And I know I'm like feeling, as I'm speaking, I'm feeling this envy story. It's like, I'm so envious that they got their way. I'm so envious that this happened. So there's some envy. It's like, no matter, you're either on this side or that side. And whoever's on the one side will say, well, we're the good side. And then they're the bad people. And then it'll be vice versa. It doesn't matter. And that's just how it's going to be. So it's always a no-win situation that we get ourselves into when we get into those battles. And so when we're envious and jealous, or we're so determined to get our way that we destroy. And so the envy is coming in to show us that it's time, that this is now, whatever is happening up here, because I don't deal with you guys down here so much, whatever is happening up here, there's a big paradigm shift. There's a big shift that is happening in the world, and, you know, in the universe out here, outside of here, as they've been witnessing what's been going on, giving the free will choice for us to be able to choose, is that I feel as if like there's a new door opening, and there's new doors kind of opening everywhere, all the way around. I'm like, there's these new doors. And as I'm seeing these doors open, is that I'm seeing there's cracks of light. And so there's light is coming in, so we can sit back and we can be mad, we can be jealous, we can be envious, we can be anything we want to be, or we can open the doors. And I feel like when we open the door, it's like letting the old out and then letting in a breath of fresh air. Take a breath of fresh air. Take a breath before we start to speak with, you know, in words that are disempowering and not empowering. And look at the language that we're using. Look, bring awareness to that language, and look back at, you know, when you're thinking, well, why is somebody so upset right now? Look at where you were yourself a month ago. Look at where you, right? And so take time to really observe that sometimes those eyes that you're looking in is no different. They're the same person. They're the same as you, but with a different view of life, or a different, believing in a different side. And see, here's our door. So it's the doors that are opening, and into the light is doors of spirit. And this is Sandra and Taylor, the Oracle of Energy Oracle cards, and look down. And it's like, and so the doors that are opening up is spirit is here. There's so many angels and guides with us right now. And there's so many opportunities for us. And even though it's hard to see that right now, is that this week, the end, what I'm picking up is that there's opportunities to love, opportunities to forgive, opportunities to make a change, opportunities to be more empowering, and opportunities to keep growing, excelling, evolving. There's so many things that are here. And I'm like, as heavy as the energy may seem, I do see something so beautiful on the other side of this. And I'm like, walking away. It's like we're walking away from all that's no longer serving us. And it's like moving into what's going to make me a better person. What's going to make me feel better? What's going to empower my life? What's going to give me the best life that I can live for me. And part of that is, you know, when you stop trying to fix everybody else and trying to fix the world, and we put focus on ourselves and, you know, maybe some of my own actions and behaviors I need to look at. And so we've been on, so we're walking away from the past. We're moving into taking a new journey. And I feel like there's a lot of unknowns right now. And I'm picking up, there's a lot of unknowns and there's a lot of unknown energy that we're sitting in, but there's also, I just keep seeing circles. And I keep seeing these circles, and it's like in that circle, it's like the spinning. So, and I'm like that mirror on the wall nursery rhyme type of thing. Is that who's the fairest of them all? And it's like, what are you looking at when you look into the mirror? You know, are you looking at judgment and anger and frustration? And when you look back at to some of our behaviors and actions and trying to get our own way, some of those markings are still on us. Cause if we got that mud and dirt on our face that we behaved like how we thought, or, you know, how we thought other people were, how we think other people may be behaving. It's like, maybe we need to take a good look at how am I going to clean up my own act? How am I going to clean up my story? How am I going to start to clean up how I got myself trapped in this fear story or this desire story that I became so passionate about something that I lost my way into of myself. And so that is very present for us right now. I also have, I'm going back to the door, I'm all over the place with doors of spirit, because I feel as if universal energy that's coming in. It's kind of like, okay, you're all forgiven. Now, can you all just start doing something better? Can we all just start doing something? And it's not that everybody needs forgiveness. It's just to mean that as a coexisting world, that we could start being so not nice to each other, kind of ostracizing people. There's been a lot of ostracizing. If you don't agree with this, you don't agree with that, then you're not good enough for me, or you can't be here. And it's like, and there's a difference in, you know, there's boundaries, and people being assholes are assholes. And if they're being assholes to you, you need boundaries. If they're disrespecting that you have a different view, then yeah, that's on them. So it's like, this is about us. Now I'm moving into the quantum oracle. This is also Sandra and Taylor. I got all Sandra and Taylor tonight. And so it's honoring your path. And I feel like it's like celebrating yourself, celebrating your win. As much as we've been through all this, those doors of opportunities are showing up. Those doors of stepping into our higher self, into our soul self, into the beautiful self, and honoring who you are from, you know, how we come out on the other side of setting an intention to be the best version of ourselves, to do the best things that we can. And this is, see, the higher self. And this is like stepping into our higher self, seeing your beautiful golden, seeing your beautiful diamond self. And there's a little heart, diamond heart, and here's pink. And I'm like, that's my logo. I have two logos. So that's one of my logos. And I actually have over here on a giveaway thing we're getting ready, I actually have that pink diamond that's in this picture. Like, it's right there. And it's got like little angel wings. So taking, you know, to our higher self is who we're speaking this week. We are moving into the higher self energy. Speak to your higher self. Don't be speaking to the world out there so much as you're speaking to your higher self. It's time to go inward, time to come back to you, time to return to connecting to spirit, and time to let them guide us. Time to allow them now to, you know what, we've been running wild for a while trying to be influenced so much, or being influenced by the outside world. It's time for us to be influenced from the spirit world, time for us to be influenced by our higher self, and having the courage to be willing to walk in the dark and walk a new path, and to just know that, yes, it's like there's always these paths that we're going to have to walk always. And it's like, sometimes you just got to remember there's always a light in the dark. And the energy is telling me that, you know, we have to look at everybody as an individual person, not to be clustering people together and labeling people right now, that it's time for us to stop taking off the mask. And I mean, what's behind our own shadow self, what's behind how we've been reacting and responding. And that as much as we like to cluster people together, that not everybody's alike, because everybody is unique and everybody has a different why. And, you know, people might have been on in support of one thing, but it might have been for a whole different reason than what you have told yourself the story on. And so go deep. This week it's about go deep. Dive a little deeper. go a little deeper into self-discovery, go a little deeper and let your higher self, instead of our triggered emotions, do the speaking for us, do the deciding for us, and allow ourselves to really, truly return to the relationship where we need to have it. We've been, and so it's that whole fear factor we've been feared into. So we're always being feared in this social media news world that just, like, I'm not even going to lie, it drives us insane from the essence of divine. It's like, cause it's like, there's only truth is the truth behind the veil. And I'm like, there's that side, there's this side, and there's so many things. And it's like, in life, if we're taught, there's lessons like that sense of lack of, it's like everything is in cycles, and there's a cycle that's ending and there's a new cycle that's beginning. But it's like, when we're getting, you want to be sure that if you're going, that you're getting a little bit of this and a little bit of that, that little bit of this and a little bit of that came from something that was so much bigger. And so if you look at only the seed of the tree and you say, well, that's never going to provide for me, that's never going to be enough, what is that ever going to do? And you see a lack of, well, plant that seed, right? And it's like, and so you see that tree, you see that seed grow into a tree, and then you see the apples, or you see the, you know, other fruit, and then you see these things. Well, now you see opportunity, right? Because if you can see beyond, or if you start planting a new seed, then you're going to grow something new again. So this is us moving away. So there's a lot of traveling. There's a lot of shifting of energy, and it's shifting very quickly right now. One day it can be beautiful. The next day it could be stormy. It's like, there's a lot of things changing. There's a lot of things up in the air, and not everything is fully set in stone or settled yet. And I just feel like it's not time to unpack your bags. It's not time to get all settled in. It is time to start to just reflect on you. It's like you're just cleaning house right now, getting ready for the next phase, but doors are opening, and behind those doors is spirit, and behind those, and within that spirit world is an opportunity, is a chance to observe, to see, to witness something more beautiful than what we have been witnessing. And I think there's still a lot of wait and see. And I hope in some way that this makes sense to you this week, and have a beautiful week, and I will see you again next week. Much, much love to you all. Thank you so much.